Hello, hello, Mr. Nyren here. So we're back in Tsardoms Total War. I'm playing the Eastern Roman Empire, and they are known as the Roman Empire here. They are the Eastern Roman Empire. Okay, and we're about to fight the battle. The battle of, Hadrianoupolis. Okay, and I started this campaign last year in September, I believe, so we will continue. It's version 1.1, so it's an early release from before the official release. I want to just continue my let's play, so I don't want to restart it. We are attacking the other Roman faction, the Cantacuzaeon. Cantacuzaeni. Okay, and the general Ioannes Batatzes with 451 men are inside. We are attacking. It's a siege battle. We will start the battle immediately.
No matter how they beg, let none escape. Attack!
So this was the open beta, or closed beta actually, that I received before the mod was released. So I got a copy of the closed beta. So it's an old version, might not be the most stable. I don't know. We have no sound, because when I used the custom sound and such, the Roman faction couldn't be played as. Okay, start deployment. So here we have the general's bodyguard. And our leader here. We have three generals in the army. I'm not sure which generals exactly who the characters are, but we'll see. The units are gorgeous. So I believe in the new version that some units had to be removed, but I don't know if it was any Roman units. I think it was Italian units that they had to remove, and some other stuff from that version as well. but in this version we have the original rosters. The Roman units look great. They are similar to the units in, the Great Conflict, but different, not exactly the same. Okay. So one of the swordsmen carrying a siege tower. The spearman unit is carrying the ladder there, then another spearman unit. Contaratui spearman carrying a ladder, siege tower. Ram is carried by archers, we don't want that. They will be used for a different role. Town watch, Viglai town watch, they could take up the ram. But we don't probably need both rams. So we had an archer unit here too, we do not need. There, we'll use the infantry for the ram. Ladders could be on the side. Sluice formation. They are Toxotai. I don't want Toxotai to carry the ladder. We'll move them back as well. We let the militia carry the ladders. Towers are handled by better troops, so that's fine. I just don't want any archers or javeliners to carry ladders, siege towers, or rams. Okay, let's start the battle. See that the East of Rome or EOR textures are in use here for the Roman cities, and that they have some cool structures inside, I believe. The East of Rome textures. Okay. So the enemy army, they have some town watch, Viglai town watch. Might be the same that we have. Yeah, we have the same unit, probably used a different scan. Maybe they're the same. Might be a mercenary unit for us. They are also the Romans, so could be a Roman unit. We are sharing units with other Roman faction after all. So here they have archers. They seem to be mercenaries. They are not Greek. They look Middle Eastern. Okay. Or Turkic. Okay, here we have a horse archer unit. A banner carrier there. Okay. Let's attack the ram. I mean, the gate with the ram. Okay, and we'll send the ladders towards the wall. The siege towers towards that wall. More ladders against the wall. The final siege tower should also be moved. We only had one. No, I think we had two. Yeah. Send them towards the wall over there. These spearmen, the Contaratui spearmen, they look kinda cool. Oh, they're being fired at from the wall. So yeah, we have some East of Rome skinned buildings and such. Maybe they have done some of their own skins too, I don't know, on these buildings.
Our men have reached the walls with their ladders.
Tsardoms to the war team, I mean. This is the third episode in my Let's Play. I don't know why I didn't continue it last year. Maybe I got busy with other games and then with modding, and then just didn't play more. I'll try to be more active now and upload a new episode of each of my ongoing Let's Plays more frequently. I want to finish my old Let's Plays. Here we have their bodyguard.
The ladders are now in place.
The
walls are no match for valor and fortune.
KUE bodyguard.
The battering ram is in place. It will not be long before our enemy's defenses fall.
We KUE bodyguard.
Our siege towers have reached the walls.
So we will play this campaign until we have achieved our goals, or until the game can't be continued if it's too unstable. When we are done with this campaign, if it's ended because of instability or something, we will just start another version of this mod. So I have the latest version, the 1.5 version, and I also have the 1.3 version released in December. The first official version.
Praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
But I will I have the 1.3 version released in December, but with fixes, I believe. Then I have the 1.5 version. So the difference is that certain things were removed from the 1.5 version and replaced by other stuff because of I believe some models and other stuff they didn't have permission.
Our siege towers have reached the walls. Now the butcher's work begins.
So they didn't have permission for all the assets, but they thought that they had that. There were a misunderstanding because the modders who made those resources were Russians, so they misunderstood each other.
The gates have fallen.
The creators of the mod are probably English and American and such, Eastern European and the creators of those assets were Russians, so there were a misunderstanding, so they had to remove those assets. But they released an official version, 1.3, I believe it fixes and stuff before removing it, because of that issue. So I have all of the versions. So this is 1.1, the closed beta. So it might be too unstable to be playable for more than a short while. I don't know exactly if we will be able to continue it to the end, or if it will force me to end it quickly. If this campaign is forced to end before I'm done, I will just start a new one. 1.3. Okay. Which is the first public release with some updates, I believe. Maybe it's the first publicly released version. Some fixing and stuff. Okay. Clearly see that the light armored troops have no chance against the armored troops. But armor matters in the game mode. This game, this mod, Tsardoms Total War, they aim to be very, very historically accurate, so they want the troops to be historically accurate as well. Here we have their general's bodyguard. Okay. We'll send one of our bodyguards against them and move our troops here. Ah, we are fighting here. Okay, I'm fighting there too. I'm not used to have yellow like circles, they used to be green. In this mod they are yellow and do not look as colored. You can actually see the ground beneath the circle. They only have a small like ring with the color. They seem to have changed the UI stuff.
Enemy are badly blooded. They have lost half their men.
Okay, cavalry versus cavalry. We sent one of the bodyguards here, but one of the lesser generals. We sent the third.
Grace to God.
I believe
we have captured the enemy's walls.
So cavalry in this mod is very hardy. You can fight for quite a while. Won't go down easily. Especially the heavy armor and bodyguard. We KO bodyguards. music in this version. To the sound, but that's very realistic. Okay, so it's good for the realistic feeling. So in this campaign I will read the descriptions of each new unit that we recruit. I believe I've already read about the units we have in this army. And then I will also focus a lot on the events and such that happen. We are playing the historical accurate campaign with scripts and everything, including the script that will cause the plague to happen. We will lose troops to the plague on certain dates. Don't particularly enjoy that script, but I want to play it as they intended it to be played. They allowed all the events and scripts and such. That's why we are very aggressive, so that we can lose as many as possible in battle and as few as possible to the plague. We wouldn't earn anything by having the troops in my cities and then all of them died thanks to the plague instead. That would be a waste. It's better if they die in battle than in cities.
We are under attack!
Okay. So it will be a very offensive campaign where we will try to kill as many as possible by attacking. Only waiting in cities to reinforce. Okay, so we have 16 remaining of the bodyguard. They have 10 remaining, so we should win that. Win our worst general, the austere general. Seem to have other troops here. They have the Turk Poles, horse archers. Turks. Here they have some Stratioti Lancers. Any range units. We have some dismounted range units we can send there. Sending in the Saui peasant archers. No, Siloe peasant archers. Okay. A bit away from the screen. Sometimes it's hard to read those Italian names or words. Sent in another unit of horse archers. Skirmishers do not have enough range.
General's bodyguard! Attack quickly!
So those battles between the horsemen seem to take forever. Should probably have taken some coffee to become a little bit more awake. After this video, I believe I will go and take measures to become more awake here. A bit tired still. Because I can't comment as good as usual when I'm tired. Okay, my vocabulary is worse.
Generals, hold it on.
And my ability to speak English, because it's not my first language, it's my second language, so if I'm tired, it will affect my ability to speak. If it was in Swedish, I could have spoken without problems, but the English, unfortunately, I lose out on some words and such when I'm tired. My vocabulary will be way worse. So this battle with the cavalry took forever.
General's coming up!
Okay, look like they are being fired at here. Order them to go down the wall. Go down, attack the horse archers down there. So you're just being fired at.
To praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
We'll play maybe 12 different games a day out of the ones we've already started. Every second day, so I need to take one day off processing videos and uploading them and such. So if I play today, we will upload and process the videos yesterday, tomorrow, and then the day after that we'll continue to play. Then the day after that we will process videos and upload them. Every second day I will play, and every second day I will upload videos and process them. I love how these Romans look. They're really good models. Attack the horseman, spearman. Cataratui, spearman. Charge the horseman. Okay. Send these guys there too, because they can fire their bows, we don't like that. These guys are not long range, that's good.
Spread
out. Move them spread out formation, spread loose formation.
General's holding out! General's holding out!
They have 7 remaining of their bodyguard. We have 7 too. We lost some due to the horsemen, the horse archers, the Turkopoles. They killed some of our bodyguard. Fear dismounted heroes over mounted ones. Unless they have like odd mounts like dragons. I think Game of Thrones to more enhanced. But in this mod, you will be on a horse, and that's not that interesting. It becomes more out soon than we are in this view. Then we are on a horse in general.
There
are 5 remaining. They are 5 very even battle. Even though we had some spearmen aiding us here too. Just attack the bodyguard soldiers. Actually, you could retreat. Send in the other general, full unit, to take care of their leader. They will probably kill a few of our spearmen, as they are probably overpowered against the infantry, but we will send in the second unit of cavalry. Because otherwise we risk losing our general here. He had about the same numbers, still alive. Instead of wasting a general, because he will replenish his troops after battle, so instead of wasting him, we send in the other one. A banner carrier. General himself. Okay. Probably an officer there too. We're attacking our infantry here. We would probably win without the help of the cavalry, but we'll send them in anyway. We have 5 remaining, including a banner carrier. Here comes our cavalry. Kill their leader, his bodyguard. Really beautiful mounts and riders. Believe this city will fall.
We are blessed. Yeah. The enemy general is dead. We have sent the idiot to hell.
Ioannis Batatzes has fallen. Send our cavalry against their cavalry here. So infantry is at a disadvantage. We have spearmen. Comparative spearmen. That's good. That they are spearmen at least. Spearmen are good against cavalry. We might be able to win tomorrow. But we'll send our bodyguard here. Right, now they are getting slaughtered. Really remember what the clock was. Let's see.
General, holding on, attack quickly!
We are winning the battle. We We killed 97%, we killed 30%. So they have the red Roman colors there, red and yellow. We have the purple colors. It started to stop there.
Praise the Almighty!
Let's our end the battle. It's a siege
this
battle.
This is a clear victory that goes to only men of great virtue and valor.
Nice, clear victory. Ioannes Apocaucus won against Ioannes Batatzes. Okay. And we had 1693 men, they had 451 men. We lost 440, they lost 441, so almost the same losses, same numbers and losses. Okay, we have 1253 remaining after the battle. We killed 378, and we killed 61 additional enemy troops when they were broken. Okay, and the enemy have 10 remaining. They killed 500, including 13 when they were broken. Okay.
We tore them apart, my lord.
Okay, Hadrianoupolis was conquered.
Victory!
Just walk in and we'll get 2070 florins. And no one will be massacred. We could bang a few heads, in other words, sack the city. Then we will massacre 4,432 men and civilians actually. And then Florence will be gained 10,301. And we can also let them have it or exterminate the settlement. And that would gain us the most florins, I believe. 15,827, and no, we'll get less florins than if we sack the city. We get 8,241, and we will instead kill 15,000. This is a Roman city, so we do not want to kill the population. But I dislike when areas revolt, so normally I would exterminate a settlement or let them have it. But in this case, we can sack the city to get the most resources. Submerge the troops. We'll have some losses in the battle. Can retrain troops. Okay. Here we can get diplomats, assassins, and spies. We also have some troops. We can't recruit them this time. This is a Roman region capital, Tima. Okay. I think we can go for that. We have a new area. An army route. Ioannes Apocaucus. Whatever. Holding these areas on the map. So we had the capital of Constantinopolis from the beginning, conquered Galmata from the, I believe, one of the crusading states, and then we started with a few areas. We have been fighting the Turks, but we haven't taken any areas from them. Okay. spy here. This is the closed beta 1.1 of Tsardoms Total War. Started the campaign, so I want to finish it. Okay, after that we'll update the mod to at least version 1.3 and try another faction. And after that maybe we'll try a campaign in the 1.5 version, the latest one. Okay. Unless there has been another update like 1.6 or something, but I don't believe that's the case. Okay. So we have 9 regions, 12 generals, and we have 4 castles and 5 cities. We have won 10 battles, lost 1 battle, and the year is 1348, I believe, or 1340, but I think it's 1348. I'm a bit away from the screen, so it's hard to see. Turn number 6. Have a map here of our areas, the white areas, and other areas. Okay. Other factions and the mods. We are allied to Tsardom of Serbia and the Tsardom of Bulgaria. Our enemies are Kantakousinos, the rival Roman faction, and then we are at war with the Ottoman Empire, which is the Turks, and the Emirate of Aden. Okay, and we are also at war with the Republic of Genoa, because we took that area next to Constantinople from them. And then we are at war with the rebels, of course. So then we have the other factions. We have the Kingdom of Hungary, Kingdom of Croatia, Banato of Bosnia, Republic of Ragusa, Tsardom of Serbia, Tsardom of Bulgaria, Principality of Wallachia, Principality of Moldova, Kantakousinos, Romans, Duchy of Athens, Knights of St. John, Ottoman Empire, Empire of Aydin, Emirate of Karaman, Emirate of Karaman, the Golden Horde, which is the Mongols, Republic of Venice, Duchy of Milan, Republic of Genoa, Republic of Florence, Papal States, which is the Pope, Kingdom of Sicily, Kingdom of Trinacria, Kingdom of Trinacria, Duchy of Austria, and the Swiss Confederacy. Okay.
Was that an attack?
So we have
no
a general
words.
Here.
Draw your sword.
Manuel Asana's general. Check our settlements. I think we have constructed in every area. Yeah. I usually do that before I move the troops. We are also recruiting. Okay, we're done. Conquered Hadrianoupolis from the other Roman faction.
Who do I face?
We have Ioannes Apocaucus, general.
Yes?
And Andreas Ioannes, general. And
orders?
Michael Asanes, general. Okay.
Command me. Orders.
Leave one unit here of General Spodgard. Move out and kill this general.
Send them to hell or worse. March.
They retreated.
Victory. Yes.
Okay, we will do a simple thing here.
Move out. Let's attack, my lord. My lord.
Okay, let's fight this battle too and kill that general. Okay. Start the battle.
Waste no time of sparing enemies this day, man. Finish them all.
But want to progress a bit in every episode. But so I'm still controlling most of the army. Then I did a mistake. That's not what I wanted. Let's exit and load.
Today's defeat is nothing.
I don't know what went wrong there. Something went wrong. I have to load the save.
Continue tomorrow, my lord.
Control the other army. Yeah, that wasn't supposed to happen. I was supposed to move.
What do I face? Orders?
Command
me. Yes?
Supposed to move the army there.
Who do I face?
Now we can move it. Okay, we'll do this.
Yes, my lord. This is where we shall meet.
Okay, and now we'll start the battle.
Yeah,
we'll control the big
glory,
army.
And most of all, victory!
Start deployment. We are only controlling a general here. We go to UI options. Put this on slide. Exit that tab. We'll go back or force, start the battle, reinforcements, Ioannis, Epicaucus, okay, he'll arrive here, his troops will, so we do not have shootout stance, well, I could still use it, but the button is invisible, but I could click on it, good, so we have placed the arm on shootout stance against the enemy. Actually, I don't need them to shoot out, it's against a bodyguard unit. Let's just attack. They have a bodyguard here. Roman bodyguard unit.
Forward!
The kind of Cosenoi faction. The rebel faction within our lands that we need to defeat first. There are troops. These are Turkopole horse archers. Turkopole's horse archers, okay. I'm surprised they have this band. Maybe they are not Turks. I don't know. I don't remember. I remember reading about them in one of the older episodes. Can't remember the details. Enemy unit is over here. They can't retreat. They will all fight to the death in this battle. Sent an entire army to handle their general. Hey, counteract is spearman over here. And Spatatu is swordsman, they are actually better swordsmen, I believe. Than ordinary troops. Oh, Toxotai skirmishers have started to fire upon the enemy. And our Turkopole's horse archers too. They have heavy armor. They are not easily taken out by arrow fire. T take quite a few hits with the arrows. Looks very good, this mod. Looks much more modern than some of the other historical titles. Now they are charging there. Not good. I can only order my bodyguard unit to attack, and he's not close. Their bodyguard seems to be far away. They are sending forward some of the spearmen now. And cavalry. Eagle-eye hippies. And the scouts of the faction. They killed some of our Xotai skirmishers. They are charged. The Viglai town lords have spears, that's good. They still would be easily killed by the bodyguard.
Forward!
This unit of Turkopoles, they use leather mail, chain mail, I think. Lamellar and chain mail. Here comes my bodyguard. It's Spatati, sword player. Maybe I should have used the bodyguard against them. Now we lost a lot of infantry troops. We didn't need to lose. Because the bodyguards in this mod are really tough. If I had sent only my general, they would have probably won the battle, but because I believe we are playing on very hard in both battle and campaign, giving the enemy bonuses back. But with two bodyguards we would have won. Could have used the two bodyguards. We lost some of our troops. We probably are losing some of our own troops.
They have lost half their men.
So yeah, I did a mistake. I should have only sent the cavalry against them. We're probably killing more of our own troops with the javelins, arrows. So we will win the battle. They lost 57%, we lost 16%. Here are the Peltas die, Javelin, and the other bodyguard in control there. Okay. Let's move back. I can't control it. Okay.
It is unwise to praise the day before sunset, but our men are winning the battle and forging a worthy victory.
Now the other bodyguard is joining. Only four remaining of the enemy bodyguard.
The Lord above is kind. We have captured the enemy's general. Okay. This is a clear victory that
Manuel
goes
to
all men of great virtue and valor.
Good job, soldiers. We won. Okay, so we killed 100%. We took the enemy captured. And 15% allies killed. Okay, so they killed 154 for troops. So we can execute him, we can release him, or we can ransom him. The choice is obviously either execute or ransom. Ransom value 172. We'll execute him because he belongs to the rebel faction of the Roman Empire. We don't want him alive. Okay, trade increase. Andreas. Sanus, Andreas Sanus feels appreciated. Okay. Trade increase. Winning first, okay.
Let me strike, buddy. Yes, Lord. Creating a huge force.
Lost a few
force.
Units there.
Who do I face?
They have a fort without a garrison. It's not belonging to an enemy, it's belonging to an ally. Can't attack it. It's belonging to the Tsardom of Bulgaria. Okay.
You are lazy. Come here if you have a treaty to offer.
You expect me to come to you, infidel?
We are defending here, so if we are being attacked here, we have an army there. Ready to defend. An agent.
Hello,
a princess. Next to Cantal Cosena. Okay, spy.
Do, sire.
The diplomat. We've already moved the diplomat and the princess, sire. But the spy could be moved now. We have the spy inside of Turkish territory. We'll keep him there. Oh, we could be moved towards the front against the Roman rebels. Bulgarian stuff over there. Let's move the army here.
Yes.
Let's fast forward.
Coming here, my lord.
Okay, and so our first goal is to take out the other Roman faction and unite the Roman Empire. And the second goal is to take care of the Ottoman Empire. They have cavalry advantage. Horse cavalry. Horse archer cavalry advantage. They are a threat. In a later game, they might get really good stuff like bombards and such. The Wrath of God, Genoa, Venice, and Pisa are reached in early 1348. During the summer, the plague spread to the rest of the Italian peninsula. So Aragon, the Maghreb, and south central France arriving. Excuse me. We're a bit from the screen. Genoa, Venice, and Pisa are reached in early 1348. During the summer, the plague spreads to the rest of the Italian peninsula. To Aragon, the Maghreb, and south central France, arriving at the gates of Paris. Also on the eastern front, the terrible disease spreads rapidly in the Greek and Balkan area. Corpses litter the streets at the mercy of stray dogs and mice. Other ghastly realities include abandoned houses, fires, screams of pain, nauseating odors, graves with hundreds of bodies stacked up, scourge so dreadful. Cannot be other than the manifestation of the wrath of God against man. Okay. New mission. Source: the Council of Nobles. It's a vanilla mission. Description: there are foreigners at our. Okay. There are foreigners almost at our very gates, and we know very little of them. council suggests you should send an emissary to the faction and initiate diplomatic relations, Kingdom of Hungary. Okay. Yeah, and they want us to go to this area. Okay, but they are far away, so we won't prioritize that. We have 5 turns. Maybe we should send someone there. Wait a second.
Your Highness.
There, exactly. We are probably far away.
Happily, my lord.
Try to move her there.
Very well. Royalty needs its rest, my lord.
Okay. It'll take a while to get there. We are waiting our time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. She won't get there in 5 turns, unfortunately. Where is our our diplomat then?
Yes, my lord.
Oh, he's closer, I think.
Naturally, my lord.
Let's see.
Today's journey
one,
ends.
1, 2, 3, 4. So we might get there in time. Maybe not. Death stalks the land. Settlements affected Constantinople, is the capital, and some other areas. Kaidestos, Raidestos actually, Kallipolis, Pigai, Mytilene, Pelayo Castro, Galata, Didymotion, Hadrianoupolis. Characters affected, all of these guys. So we lost 13,788 citizens and 575 soldiers. Not good. End of turn report. So militarily, Kingdom of Hungary is the strongest faction, and we are on the 11th place. I don't exactly know how many factions there are in the mod, but there are a few, and then overall the Kingdom of Hungary is also the strongest. Kingdom of Sicily has the largest population, they have the best production, and the Ottoman Empire has the best financial situation. New mission, already checked that. Trade increase. Michael Philanthropinos, fair and rule. Okay. Construction report. Palayu Castro, we have a market, and in Didymotion, we have a port. Recruitment report. Galata, we have a unit of Jaya spearmen. In Didymotion, we have a contestai javelinman. In Constantinopolis, we have retrained Toxotai. And in Pegai, we have Turkmen tribal horsemen retrained. In Mytilene, we have Vigai hippies retrained. Then we have some other areas where we have retrained units too. Okay. Alliance announced. The Duchy of Athens and the Tsardom of Serbia. We are allied with the Tsardom of Serbia. Okay. Path blocked. Irene. Palaiologos. Princess. Okay. So we are year 1348. Turn number 7.
Let me strike.
Could use some reinforcements. We have only generals nearby.
My lord.
You have a unit of a contestai javelin man. Send them down to the army.
Name thy enemy, lord. Yes, marching. Approaching, my lord.
We want to attack somewhere.
We march. A superb ambush location. We shall send them to hell or worse. March.
Could build a ship, but we don't want
when
to do
shall
that.
We attack the walls, then, my lord?
Send another unit to reinforce the army.
Move out! We march no further today, lord.
Who do I face?
Very weak garrisons, only generals. But here, this border, we have more troops. Don't like that we have the elite army there.
Command me.
Could probably move them out. I mean, Constantinople is an important city. But we want the army to be in use somewhere, not die to the plague. We have a ship here too. We can move them to the ship and maybe use them against the Turks. Okay, so we have... here we have some Siphonatores. Flamethrowers, really good unit.
Yes.
Cavalry could be used on the front against the Turks. Okay, we will move out the troops.
Onward.
We have some cavalry lancers and Dynatui nobles and Permonai hippies guards. Okay. All of them cavalry. We'll also move out the big guy hippies. Five units of cavalry. And the horse archers, of course. The Turk and Poles horse archers, they are very much needed against the Turks. Okay, Cretan archers could be moved out.
Mining forces, my lord.
And your majesty. Any extra units like that.
Orders.
Okay, so these are foreign troops. Peasants. Yeah, yeah, spearmen. Okay.
Your majesty.
I think we could use some elite troops somewhere.
Your majesty. Orders. Yes. Orders.
We could move with one of the archers.
Bringing our troops together.
Foot guard could be moved out.
Mining forces. Who do I face?
Leader could be moved out.
Without forces. Orders.
Both Ranging guards could be moved.
Orders.
Foot guards.
Bringing
out
our troops together. Your majesty.
Conus guards could also be moved.
Mining forces, my lord. Yes. Orders. Yes.
Okay. Tarat is spearman.
Bringing our troops together. Your majesty.
Spathat is swordsman. They will be
mining forces, my lord. Orders. Yes. Bringing our troops together. Orders.
Spearman.
Mining forces, my lord.
Okay.
Orders. Yes. Orders.
What's your one spear? Okay, this is good. Maybe we want this in the army, but they will be very good on the walls of Constantinople. But I don't like the idea of them dying to the plague.
Name thy enemy, lord.
I think we'll keep that unit in the capital.
Let me strike, my lord.
Admiring the enemy. Yes, my lord.
So we can't really move the ship, but...
This is a course we cannot plot. We will not surrender.
However, Genoese fleet here.
Yes.
Attack it immediately.
Closing to engage, my lord.
He destroyed the enemy fleet.
Our fleet is victorious! For
command me.
Can move the arm inside of the ships there. And immediately move to this side. And attack the Turkish settlement here.
My lord, should we spare any of them? Now we
here have a small garrison.
We lay siege.
Including Diade, Halberdiers, and a general, Timurtas Sogun. Sorry, Timurtas Sogle. Okay. Still had our corpse. Is there bodyguard? He's a general. Okay, the settlement is a castle. Yeah, the citadel there and the capital, of course, is a metropolis. Okay.
Name thy enemy, lord.
They are attacking that area, held by the Turks. They have an army here too, including some cavalry units. They preferred to use it in defensive roles because they weren't the best units. Most of them were ranged units or militia. Even the cavalry are militia. This is more of an elite
who
army that
face?
You can use offensively. Then we have this army unit reinforcing the army.
Let me strike.
Wanted to reinforce. Okay, how many units do we need? We have need 5 more units.
How may I serve, Sultan?
Actually, we could move out these cavalry Order. Units, the militia.
Your Majesty, move out! A good day's march ends.
We had to merge them due to the plague. We've lost a few.
Yes! Onward! Virgin armies! Orders! How may I serve, Sultan?
Okay, 32 and 52.
How may I serve, Sultan?
Okay, we'll Sultan. Move out some of them.
Mining forces, my lord.
Aid the your army over here.
We continue tomorrow, my lord.
I will check our constructions. Okay, and did the mutation. We can construct something new. Roman region capital. Let's go for that. Same in Palau Castro. I think we're done. Now it's the recruitment. Go for cavalry, maybe. Cavalry lancers, okay. And Stratioti lancers. The cavalry lancers are better, we'll go for them. Okay, and Raidestos, we can go for a Roman trip, maybe. Rallypolis, we can in Mytilene. Hadrianoupolis, we can go for a unit of Viglai Tanwatch. Actually, we could go for a spy too, and an assassin. And in the demutation, we can go for some pelt. Javelinman, Kantaratu is spearman, and Spatatu is swordman. Okay. In Palai Castro, we can go for a Roman trip and some Acontista Javelinman. And we're done. Okay, let's click enter. So we played 2 turns. At least they are attacking the army that they are besieging Christopolis. Ioannis Asanas is the enemy general. Spatatus swordsman, cavalry lancers. Okay, they even have Siphonatorus here. Okay. Withdraw from the battle.
They were lucky. Regroup now. We had a chance to take them, my lord.
They're too strong there. Soxed land. Okay. Relations report. Amiable with the Tsardom of Bulgaria and the Tsardom of Serbia, our allies. Recruitment report. Set Constantinopolis, the capital. We have a Murtatui guard archer unit ready. We also have some Zakonas marines and cavalry lancers. And we have some Roman ships built in various locations. And we have some Contestai of Leanman in Palais Castro. Peltastai of Leanman in the Domotation. And there we also have some Kandratui spearmen and Spasatui swordsmen. And in Hadrianoupolis, which we conquered earlier in the episode, we have a Viglai town watch unit, and a spy unit, and an assassin. Okay. Faction announcements, okay. End of turn report. Okay. So we will send out our new agents. A spy. We want them inside of the lands of our rival. We don't really care about the lands of Bulgaria and Serbia.
I simply cannot do this. Investigating.
Okay, nothing interesting over there.
The problem is,
what
is their name?
Move the two.
Orders. Yes! Move out! Virgin armies, my lord. We march no further today, lord.
I don't know where my cavalry is. I moved them back.
Yes, marching. Yes, lord.
So now we have a full army, but I merged the units. Now we have room for another unit.
Orders.
Let's move that unit off.
My lord. Orders.
Turkmen axemen, maybe.
Sultan! Yes! Orders!
Yeah, I think we can move a unit off.
Yes! Orders!
Turkmen axemen there.
Move out! Who do I face? Orders!
Don't move anymore this time.
Let
this front
strike,
we should be
lord.
Able to attack now.
Your Majesty! Yes, my lord! Plotting course now.
Okay.
Orders. Name thy enemy, lord.
The Conus Marines and stuff.
Yes. Your Majesty.
I think we'll just attack here.
We march on our victims.
Don't need the final siege tower. Take this area. The next battle, maybe we could take it. I think we will end here. Next episode we will take Uskadar. Okay, room. So thanks for watching. This is Tsardoms version 1.1, the closed beta, given to me in September or something, 2020. And I played the first two episodes. This was the third episode. See you later in the fourth episode. See ya.